Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're talking about dun-dun-dun-dun, bullet journal for beginners. As a beginner, like legit noob, I just started in March, and how bullet journaling is all about progress, not perfection, the content of what you fill your notebook with, understanding yourself, unpacking your why, and discovering what works best for you. Sounds overwhelming? Don't fret, we're gonna break it all down today, starting with what is a bullet journal? Do I need to read the bullet journal method before starting? What supplies do I need to start? How does it work? Featuring flip through. To start, what is a bullet journal? Bullet journaling is a way to externalize our thoughts and to help declutter our minds, kind of like Han Marie for our insanely chatty brains. In the words of the creator of the bullet journal method, Ryder Carroll, he says it's part organization, part soul searching, part dream weaving. I love this. And it is to help track the past, organize the present, and plan for the future. According to the bullet journal website, it's best described as a mindfulness practice disguised as a productivity system designed to help you organize your what while you remain aware of your why. The goal of the bullet journal is to help its users live intentional lives, ones that are productive and meaningful. I'm all about this, that intentional living. I love that. Let's dig a little deeper. So what exactly is intentional living? It's the art of making our own choices before others make them for us. Why be intentional? Because going on autopilot is just merely existing. I believe it's so much more worthwhile to strive to live rather than just exist and just kind of go through your days like a little robot, which is, you know, what I did for most of my youth and even sometimes now, but I'm working on it. In summary, the bullet journal to me is just a really powerful system for self-reflection. It is an extension of my thoughts, so that means it's basically an extension of me. And like Ryder said, each bullet journal becomes another volume in the story of your life. Does it represent the life you want to live? If not, then leverage the lessons you've learned to change the narrative in the next volume. So yes, I'm quoting Ryder Carroll a lot in this little intro, but because this system is his system and his methodology, he deserves all the credit because he's the one who wrote it. He's the one who came on with it. Okay, moving on. Do I need to read the bullet journal method before I start? So this is the book that Ryder Carroll wrote. In short, I don't think you need to, but it would be really helpful if you do because there are giant nuggets of wisdom in that book. It's so much more than just a book on how to bullet journal. The focus of the book is on the importance of intentional living, like we mentioned above, taking good care of yourself and constantly checking in with yourself and your why to make sure you're living the life you proactively chose to live. Again, quoting Ryder Carroll, it's not about living a perfect life, an easy life, or getting things right all the time. It's not even about being happy, though joy often greets you along this path. Leading an intentional life is about keeping your actions aligned with your beliefs. It's about penning a story that you believe in and that you can be proud of. Okay, enough chit-chatting. What do I need to start? So we're getting to supplies. All you really need is a notebook and a pen, about 10 minutes, and an open mind. That's it. But if you want to get a little more creative for my setup, the notebook that I have is this grid journal from Kiki K. Felicia bought this for me when she was home in Australia, and I like how it's not fully gridded because that can get kind of overwhelming. Instead, there's a bunch of little plus signs. I've mostly used Moleskine ever since I started buying notebooks and planners in 2012, so I'll probably resume after I fill this one up. I may also look into this notebook as it seems to be the most popular bullet journal notebook on the interwebs. Moving on to pens. So this Uniball Signo DX in 0.38 is my favorite pen of all time. The only downside is that it is gel, so it does bleed when you use a highlighter over this. But other than that, this is perfect. I love thin pens, and recently I picked this one up while I was in Taiwan. It's the Uniball Signo RT. Hehe, really needs high. Oh yeah. And it's also in 0.38. This also bleeds, so maybe ink pens do better. I don't know. I remember looking into this, but I forgot. So let me know if you do have an ink pen and which one is better, which one doesn't bleed. And let me know your favorite pens down below because I low-key nerd out over pens as I nerd out with a lot of things in life. How does it work exactly? before I get carried away, I'd highly recommend watching this video by Ryder Carroll explaining what the bullet journal system is and how it works. Link it down below and it'll be up there in that little icon. In the bullet journal system, there are 5 main modules or collections. It is the index, future log, monthly log, daily slash weekly log, and custom collections. If all of this is overwhelming, don't worry, I'll explain everything as we flip through my journal. So the most important thing I reminded myself before I started, and that Ryder repeated many times in the bullet journal method book, is that the content of your journal is more important than getting all fancy and creative and artsy. But if fancy, creative, and artsy will enhance your journaling experience or will motivate and encourage you to do more and to journal more and to want to do more things with your journal, then do that. But just remember, content over everything else. Basically, what you're writing down is more important than all the fluff. Time for flip through. I started my journal with a Polaroid from my trip to Jeju last October with a little note saying more days like this in 2009 because yes, I'd like to have more days like this. Less about traveling and being somewhere beautiful. This is more about how grounded and at peace I felt while I was there. Even looking at this picture alone, looking at any picture of the ocean or the beach brings me such a sense of calm. And to the right of this page is the index page. If your notebook is already numbered, just add the page number next to the title. It can be the title of any collection you add in the future. And if your notebook is a number, you gotta do it manually, man. I only number one side because I am kind of lazy and I don't see the point in numbering every single page. So the purpose of this index is so that you'll never lose any precious notes or collections that you have, and you can quickly flip to, let's say, your habit tracker for the month, or your budget for the month or the year, or your list of movies or books that you're currently reading. All right, I left a blank spread here in case my index gets a little out of hand. I don't think it will, but it's here. Next is my 2019 manifesto. At the beginning of every year, I like to create a little manifesto for myself and for how I'd like to live this coming year. And 2019 was all about commitment, ownership, consistency, and staying grounded. I made a video. We'll link it up and down below. I keep saying I'll link, but everything will be linked. As you can see, this journal is a total work in process. I got distracted or called into a meeting halfway through bolding the letters of this, so I finally filled it in 3 months later last night. And hey, better late than never, right? The next spread is the future log, where you keep all your, yep, future events in one place. You can either draw a calendar or just number all the days of the month. I choose the latter for simplicity's sake. This log is home to any task, event, or note that doesn't fall into the month you're currently in. So projects, birthdays, holidays, meetings, travel dates, anything, any date you need to block off, throw it in here. It's quite straightforward. And at the beginning of every new month, you will refer to this future log and add that to your monthly log. And before we get there, let's quickly look over the key. So on the left are the symbols. The first is task, which could be a box, it could be a dot, it can be an open circle. Whenever you complete a task, you generally cross it out or you fill in the dot. And then you can also migrate a task or you can schedule a task, which is what I'll get to in a bit. And on the right, there's a color code across all of my notebooks and digital calendars. Anything that's blue is work. Anything that's pink will be appointments. Anything that's purple will be spiritual stuff. Anything that's orange will be workout or health related. And anything that is green will be play. So any social activities, birthdays, dinners, going out, anything that's generally non-work related will fall under play. So next is monthly log. This was the first monthly calendar log I made, so mistakes were definitely made, hence using the washi tape as whiteout on top because I just didn't really like how my cursive turned out. Here you see the color code in action. I've used this color code in my digital calendar since college. On the right column, I wrote down books I'd like to read this year for my one book per month goal. I'm a little behind on finishing books, but I've started a lot of books. This would be something that's considered a custom collection, so I would write books in the index and write page 9 so that whenever I want to add to my book collection or cross something out, then it would be here. And the books that I've finished, it's crossed out completely. The books that I've started, it just has a 1/ across. Next is the daily logs, or in my case, weekly logs, because I prefer being able to see everything in a day. At first, I divided each page into three sections. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday is on one page. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday is on the next. I saw this layout on Instagram and I got super inspired, so I started using this layout with a weekly calendar on the left column and a task and to-do list in the middle. It's so cute with like the little headers, and I just added some puffy, bubbly font. Now, here where the symbols come in. So every task that you write into your notebook will be in the form of, for now, I've used a bullet point. So when you have a new task that's open, it's a bullet point. Once you finish the task, you can X it out or you can completely cross it out. I like to do this daily, weekly, and monthly. Go through your day and see which tasks remain open. If you don't need to deal with this for another month or two, schedule it into the future log by putting the left arrow or the less than sign and putting that into your future log in the beginning. And what you do is, I think I said this earlier, every beginning of the month when you're setting up your monthly log, you will refer to your future log and add in anything that you have scheduled into the future, because the future has now become the present. And so that's scheduling. And let's say if you want to migrate this specific task into a future date, like tomorrow, or like today's Monday, you want to put it on Friday, then you just put a greater than sign, which is a right arrow, and you just rewrite this task into a future date that's in the foreseeable future. And so flipping through, here are just some pages of notes. Here is a custom collection that I have. I'm taking some master classes and I'm tracking my progress for these classes. Taken two so far, I just haven't updated. And here we are at the March end of the month check-in. I like to start off every check-in with some small wins, regardless if it's big or small. This specific month, I was really happy that I made time for going back to Taipei, for spending time with my family, for being able to spend quality time with my dad, my aunt, and my grandpa, and my dad's side of the family, and my mom being able to come visit me for the first time ever. Just to come visit me. And she's been to New York for a few times, but like this is the first time she visited me to see me. Some thoughts on how the month went, what I could work on. On the right side, I did something new for the month of April. This is the bullet journal method Ryder Carroll uses for his monthly logs. It's a vertical column for all the days of the month with a day of the week next to it. I added a habit tracker on the right, which was so clutch. In the past, I didn't like using habit trackers because I would see my shortcomings as failures, but now I see them as opportunities to improve. And trackers are just that. They're just tracking your progress, because life is progress. You know, it's like, it's not failure if you miss a few months or if you miss whatever, because it's life. And then if you want to learn and if you want to improve, you need to know where you were to know where you're gonna go. And yeah, so this is April. And in summary, I realized that I actually prefer the calendar view for the monthly log. And then on the side, I'll do a separate habit tracker, which is what I did for May that I'll get to in a bit. Flipping through, this is April dreaming and focus. The beginning of every month, I've been choosing a word or two for how I want the month to go. Some thoughts and ideas, ways that I can improve. How can I make this happen? And this month, I would like to some tangible goals of like reading books. I want to take online courses, etc., etc. Here is the April review. You see how I spelled April wrong? Oh my god, so funny. So this one, I broke it down a little more concisely. So three wins, highlight of the month, I'm grateful for, thoughts in general, and what I can improve on, how I can improve. Whenever I talk about improving, I want to give myself actionable steps as to how I can improve, instead of just being like, you're terrible, you need to work on this. And it's like, okay, how? And then first and foremost, don't think you're terrible, because you're not. You're doing great. We're all doing great. And May dreaming. So word focus this month, I like to read, create, and practice more self-care. So on the right side is the May tracker that I've been filling out. And things that have a box means I desperately need this. Like if I look at my habit tracker and I see that I haven't done something for a long time, I'll put a box for that day to be like, Rowena, you need this desperately in your life. And this is the May calendar at a glance. Overall, I think it could be time consuming when you are drawing lines every week or every month, but I feel like that time you have to focus on drawing a straight line, like these simple pleasures and these little things that we do in our lives, we often take for granted. When I was a senior in college, lowest point in my life, it was really, really sad. I took an art class, best decision I ever made, because that focus you get from drawing a line straight or for cutting a line straight or just that focus, like artistic focus, I can't talk, it really helps you slow down and be super, super focused and present, which is something that I struggle with for most of my life. So with all of this, I hope you guys learned something new, and I want to end this video with one of my favorite quotes from the book that I've mentioned in my previous videos, just in case you guys need a little reminder or haven't heard this yet. And with that, I hope you guys learned something new, and that if you want to try bullet journaling, this gives you some inspo to try, or that if you are a bullet journal pro, please leave any tips or advice you have down below. I would love to learn more and to know more. And if you have a bullet journaling account on Instagram, let me know your handle or share with me your favorite handles for Instagram inspiration. All right, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you so much for joining me. Bye. Always hug for days. Goodbye, my lovely humans. See you next time. Bye.